Hi, everybody. Hi. And welcome to my new camera. And my new, I don't know, just me. Yeah. A huge thanks to Best Buy for helping me out. I mean, I knew I needed to upgrade. I mean, I had old equipment. One thing at a time. And it was Cyber Monday. Let's just say they were super, super nice. Great customer service. Yeah. I smushed things around. There's things that I kind of wanted as extras. They'll wait, because I got myself this. And yes, I did film this, you know, makeup haul thing yesterday. Ipsy wasn't in yet. Plus, I wasn't 100% sure about how the setup works, because I do control it with my phone. And then I've got like a mirror behind it to see the viewer, whatever. It works, okay? You work within our budget. And why not do it again? Just why not? It's something that, for me, is an escape. It's something, you know, makes me feel good. And yes, for everybody, this one is about makeup. So if you don't like makeup, then you can stop watching. It's okay. So yes, it's about makeup. And I'm gonna call it a makeup haul, because I've had teeny weeny things here and there, and this is all just together. So it's probably gonna be like half an hour of makeup. So if you like makeup, stick around. If you don't, not much. But yesterday was a rough day. My family doctor, he's new. I've only had him for like a month and a half. Finally realized that, yeah, I am in the beginnings of kidney failure. And we've known for a while, just nobody stands up and helps me with anything. So I am really feeling all alone. Because my family, they don't care. I guess they do, but I don't know what their problem is. Anyway. Either way, I'm on my own, with the exception of like three people. And then I realize I have all of you guys. So, you can all be my family. Yeah. So let's start with makeup. So, Ipsy did come in, and this is my last Ipsy, I believe. I mean, I put on hold for 3 months, obviously, camera thing. But I wasn't too happy with like the selection that I was getting, so we'll see what's going to be up in 3 months. If you want to keep it or not. But I did get the extra items. It's a long story, and it took a long time to get here because Canada was on strike. What can you do? So this is the little bag it came in. Super cute. It's like a leathery kind of feel to it. It's purple with black little hearts on it. Now I did realize when I did the video yesterday that like showing you close-up things doesn't really work. It's not, the camera isn't, you know, highest quality, and it works great. I'm not complaining because I can afford it. But close-up things don't always work, and maybe it will go along because there's a lot of functions on there that I still don't know how to make them work. But that's with the card in Ipsy. Happy Friendsgiving, what you're thankful for, okay? There's no emoji for highlight. It's true, there is no emoji for highlighter. We need one, okay? I love highlighter because there's gonna be a lot of highlighter in this, by the way. Just letting you know, okay? But we all know that I love me some good highlighter. Yeah. And I did join one of those online petition things so that we could have the lobster emoji. And then I let them go because I'm being weird. But okay, so, Ipsy. First thing is this Juno & Co. Micro Velvet Sponge. So, for those of you who aren't aware, Taylor is one of my favorite YouTube people to watch. I've recently had to stop watching my OG. I started watching YouTube, I started getting into makeup by watching Kristen Leanne's videos. My comment is there, and people have read it. I feel like she sold out to CoverGirl. That's my personal opinion. I'm done. Anyway. So, but I do like Taylor a lot. I will link her channel below. I'll probably link one of her videos as well because there's something that I did actually buy from Sephora. Okay, we're not in the same pay gap, me and Sephora, but made an exception because she talked about it and it's something I wanted. I'm actually having it on my eyes today. I had another look with it yesterday. I wasn't too happy. Not the point. There's a lot of colors to play in there. So I'll probably link that video to later. But again, I love Taylor. She's drama-free. And I really trust her reviews on stuff, because if she doesn't like something, she'll tell you. Same thing goes for Tati. She's been around for a very, very long time, And people sometimes give her a lot of... But she tells the truth. I mean, I really trust her reviews. Again, she gets sent things or she'll buy it. I mean, she happened to marry someone who had money. So what? She still married him for love. I mean, if you watch their unboxing videos, they're great. So she can afford to buy the, you know, expensive Givenchy stuff. But she also talks highly about Wet n Wild products. So her reviews are never, I trust them. Because she'll say bad things about expensive stuff and bad things about cheap, the other way around. So those two are pretty much who I stick with. And Jackie Aina. I hate how she tells everybody, subscribe, subscribe, subscribe. Which is why I don't feel like, I don't like telling you guys to please subscribe. I mean, you can if you want to, because I'd love feedback. I have no way of knowing if anybody likes what I'm doing or saying feedback. But I find it kind of a little bit annoying. But, however, we have to go somewhere, and this needs to be said. I don't need money. This isn't, I mean, I do this for fun. I do this because I like it. It makes me feel better. I love giving out the information. But money-wise, I don't get paid, and you know, I'm starting to get into the campaigns, but not the point. If I'm ever paid to promote something, I'll always let you know. But I don't need that. When it comes to people like Jackie Aina and Tati and Taylor, that's their job. Oh, Jessica Braun, I love her too. She just decided to do this full time, so I'm super excited. I'll link her channel below. All the channels will be linked below. But that's their job. For me, if I don't make any money off of this, it's okay. My bills are still paid and I still eat and whatnot, so we're fine. And speaking of eating, speaking of that, it's a little bit later in the day right now because there's a storm that's going to start because I'm in Canada, all right? East Canada, we always have storms. And tomorrow was my day with my person that helps me go out into grocery stores and stuff because I have too much anxiety to do that on my own. She's a very nice lady. She's kind of like a buffer when people, you know, she helps me out with stuff. And she was able to squeeze me in right around lunchtime so I could do my grocery today because tomorrow is going to be a storm. And, you know, even though they're there to help me, they don't want to risk their lives to help me. So tomorrow was probably not going to be a no-go and I really need food. So, all right, first thing is this sponge. Now, I've heard everybody talk about it and I realize there's instructions in there. So make sure, to use dry products. So if you want to use, dry products, like you want to bake or something with it, you use the sponge dry. Very true. And, if you want to use it with liquid foundations, you have to wet it first, just fine. That's how you use every other beauty blender. Or if you're like, I love her, Mia Maple, a booty blender. So I do have a few that I watched. And same thing for RachhLoves. Love, love, love her. Love her to death. So they'll all be linked below. I sound like some infomercial. And it says not to use too much the first time. So I haven't tried it yet. It does feel dense. And I have been in the market for a new beauty blender because my Real Techniques one had a little bit of mold on it and I stored it out. I'm not playing around with mold. So we're happy about this. The next thing that we have here, I kind of opened the box a little bit first for time. It is a little highlighter. If I get it out. Alright, so everything that I'm going to be showing today is cruelty free. I have a few items that are from MAC Cosmetics that aren't cruelty free. And I'm hoping they're going to get on the bag buying and start being cruelty free. Which is why I feel that Chris and Leanne sold out. CoverGirl went cruelty-free, and this is my opinion, because California has now passed their cruelty-free law for cosmetics. If they didn't go cruelty-free, they can't sell their stuff in California, and Canada is following suit, so they're going to lose a big chunk of their clients if they didn't go cruelty-free, and personally, I think that's the only reason why they went. And she's super hyped about it, and, you know, whatever, we're going to go off that subject. But I do have two items from MAC Cosmetics. They're lip gloss, they're not cruelty-free, so we're going to leave them out so that this whole thing can be cruelty-free. Alright, back to this. I've had this Nomad highlighter before in Stockholm. I gave it to my sister. My sister and I no longer speak, and that's fine. But I do like it, so let's see if I can get it in there so you can see it. You know what? think I need to turn on a light. Okay, so I've turned on a light from behind, which, by the way, are cheap lights from Dollarama. But I went to college and I learned a few things about lumens and lights. Because lumens is how you measure the strength of a light, by the way. And it's how far one candle, 1 foot or something, I don't know, whatever. It's been 10 years since college, okay? So this is the color of the highlighter. I really like it. I've had it before, so I don't swatch it. Because I'm not going to swatch everything. We're not going to have time. There's a lot of stuff. You should see what's here. The other thing that I got, it's from Tarte. So one of my favorites. One of Iza's favorites, too. So, speaking of Iza, she is my little cousin. And she's my everything. And yesterday was a really, really rough night. And she pulled me back. I was 15 when she was born, and she's pretty much been my everything since then. I'm 36, by the way. I'm super happy. I just want to let her know that she means the world to me. Alright, move on. She loves Tarte stuff. So this is, this is a great size for a blush. I mean, that's not that bad. I mean, I've been trying to find something else. We're going to talk about this Makeup Geek blush later, because I got this one from Glambot. So this is the Makeup Geek full size from Glambot, and this is the Ipsy size from Tarte. So yes, not gonna swatch it, don't have time. But I mean, I know it's Tarte, I know it's great quality. I have something else from Tarte. We'll get there in a minute. What else did I get? This INC Credible Glazing Over Find Your Light, Not Mr. Right. I actually like that message. I like that. I like how people are putting out the right messages. So, first off, I don't like this applicator because it's really flimsy. And, it's a nice dark color. So, that's the color that it comes out to be. Yeah, I can't zoom in, but that's okay. It is a very, very nice color. So, I'll leave that there. And the next thing I got, the next thing that I have in Ipsy is Skin Iceland Brightening Eye Serum. I've had things from Skin Iceland before. No problem. I'm not worried about that. I'm excited about it. And I got from Nude Cosmetics, Beach, the Balm. I don't know, one of those singles in the color Brave. And that's a really pretty color. So I don't know if you guys can pick that up. But it is a mixture of brown and purple. Ooh. And copper-ish. So let me move in a little bit closer so you can actually see. Can you see that color? It's great. I love that. It's great. Super happy. And the other thing that I got from INC Credible. Now, I know I say that I'm not too happy with the value of Ipsy these days, but that's true. However, this was in Ipsy last month, and anybody knows me, I love me some glitter. And this is Heaven in a Jar. I have realized that you can buy a bigger jar of this on Sephora. I don't think you need to. Like, it's this little, and let's see if you can pick up. Like, it's just iridescence in a jar, and I don't even know, like, where I would go to wear this. I guess I could just walk around my house and be iridescent and look like a vampire from Twilight, I guess, with no place to go. But I just dipped, like, the tip of my nail. You know, I do my nails. No, I'm not rich people, okay? It's all stuff from AliExpress and China for cheap, and I do my nails. But can you see the iridescence that it gives? I hope so. I can't really tell, but I hope you can. I mean, you don't need a lot. I just dipped in my nail. I still have a little bit on. So, yeah, that's just gorgeous. I hope you can see it. I think you can't. Right there you go. There you go. I'm learning. Learning how this camera works. And another thing that came in was this tiny little cute from Ciate. It's setting powder. Now, I did, like I said, open a little bit for, you know, time. So I'm going to pour a little bit in my hand just to see how finely milled it is. Oh yeah, it is. It is. So, yeah. Yes. we'll get back to the fact that do these little samples work? Yes, they do. And then the next thing I got this month was kale, spinach, green tea, hyaluronic acid. Superfood Air Whip Moisture Cream from Youth to the People. Stop naming things with such long names, people, okay? This is a box. I hope you can see it. And this is just the little jar, which is great. This is a great size to just try something out. Alright? You actually don't need a lot of face products, really. It smells like face cream. You don't need crazy amounts for face cream to work. That's kind of the trick. But I did get this IBY in Prosecco. I don't know what heck a Prosecco is. But I do like this shade. My skin tone is changing. And is it because of my kidneys? No, actually, it's because my liver is getting better. So my kidneys are still, you know, dying. But the rest of me is getting better. Now, my kidney damage does come from the fact that I was on lithium for like 18 years. Everything else, you know, internal organ-wise, weren't working very well because of the condition of my esophagus. So I changed my diet, lost about 100 pounds. That's all okay. But my skin tone has changed a little bit, which is great. I was worried, but I did ask my gastroenterologist. He's like, no, it's a good sign. You know, it's a healthy thing. So that's great. So I have to go to a different shade and highlighter, actually. But I like this one, so let's see if you can see it next to the iridescence. It's just dark enough, but it's still in the champagne-y kind of a color. I hope you can get it. It's still in the champagne-y kind of color, but I need to go more golden, which is why I went to... And that brings us to drugstore stuff. I did get the Wet n Wild Gold Bar. I'm happy with this. This was $4.99, and you get, like, a lot of product, okay? A lot of it. And, of course, they ball, like, it's out of the ballpark. So, my thing is, like, if Wet n Wild can bring us awesome highlighters, because everybody will admit, well, they should, that some of the best highlighters come from Wet n Wild and this Mega Glow stuff. If they can bring it to us for, like, $5, why does everything else cost, like, $75? Okay. This is one of my winner's finds. It was e.l.f. It was a pack of two. It was like $6. Makeup wipes. Let's try them. I just finished my pack of makeup wipes from Walmart. The Equate brand. Loved them. Loved them. So let's see how good the e.l.f. ones are. Taking off my swatches. Very good. Recommend e.l.f. so far. I recommend e.l.f. for a lot of things. I just don't like their customer service. Get all comfy because my chair is on wheels. My neighbors downstairs must think I'm really weird. I wheel around everywhere. So, before I get into more of the drugstore finds, I want to go to my winter finds first. So, before I get into more of makeup, more drugstore finds, more good deals, I just want to talk about the things that I have rebought for skincare, because I love them. And it's this brand. So it's Rata & Co. Now, they're from New Zealand. I have another brand that I really like from New Zealand. So you New Zealanders, man, you know skincare. This one is a face serum, but this is like my fourth repurchase. So this is like an old one. I thought it was broken when I first bought the first one because it's like white. It's like a cream. But that's how it's supposed to be. It works great. No complaints. And then I did buy a face oil as well. Because it's $7.99. I mean, the real price, I think it's... I don't know. I'll put it in here. So, it's cheaper at Winners, okay? And you don't find this stuff in stores around here. Other than Winners. Again, I'm in the East Coast of Canada where people mostly forget about us. But it's $7.99, and I really, really like this one. It's, you know, vegan friendly, 100%, you know. It's got all the stuff that I'm not allergic to. Speaking of being allergic to something, though. This I got in Glambot. Maybe some of you have heard me talk about the fact that I did buy, like, a mystery package from Glambot from Halloween, and I was very disappointed because it was not good. This was the only thing worth it in there, and it's not $100. It's about $35, I think. I'll link the link, because when I opened it, I was like, what the heck is this? Like, look at this bottle. It does not, it looks like old school medicine. Like, the stuff that, like, the ones that have the commercials from, like, old time when they used to have, like, morphine and stuff in cough medicine. But no, I read the reviews on Amazon, and they were very good, so I decided to try it. And it is amazing. I will repurchase this when I'm done with it. You put a little bit in a cotton pad after you wash your face, and you know, takes everything out, and then you rinse it off a little bit. But the reason why I'm talking about allergies is the main ingredient is apple cider vinegar in this, and I'm allergic to apples. Yeah, I'm not weird, people. I'm allergic to apples. I am allergic to every single pitted fruit, including avocados, which I tried for the first time like about a year and a half or 2 years ago. Because again, in this part of the country, we're late on getting stuff, okay? And I had an allergic reaction and whatnot. So, but this is just my skin. It's fine. It makes my skin red for a little bit. But it doesn't matter. It's cleared up my skin so much. I used to have really, really bad cystic acne. And it turns out that it was gluten. When I changed my whole diet earlier this year to help my esophagus problem, I cut out gluten and it cleared up. So, happy about that. But this helps the little bit of lingering things. It's been really helping, and I've been using it for about a week now. A little bit more over a week. Worth the price. So, back to makeup, and back to drugstore finds. So, I did get this teeny weeny little thing of Tarte Shape Tape Concealer. An Ipsy. And that was one that I had to pay extra for. And here in Canada, for some weird reason, Tarte Cosmetics, you cannot buy anything shape tape in Canada, whether it comes to the concealer, the foundation, any of it. It's all, I have to buy it either from Ulta or from Tarte themselves. So once it comes to the exchange of money, the taxes and the duties and whatnot, it comes to about $50 for just the shape tape concealer. $50 for a concealer is not in my price range. And I know that my nose is, like, white. Whatever. I'm still learning my camera, okay? So if it's really bugging you, then... sorry. It's bugging me right now, but... But what I did find, and Pinterest was good for that. I looked for a dupe. And I got this NYX Gotcha Cover. There you go. I have the color Alabaster, so it works great for me. Now, I find this covers as much as this, and I actually like this one a little bit better. It's waterproof, and for me that's a big deal. Again, I do have another autoimmune disease. Yay, more, let's add more. It makes all the mucous membranes in my body be super, super dry. It really hurts. It's called Trojans or something. S-J-O with the two little things, R-G. So, that sucks. And I get to see a specialist, but it's in like 2 months from now, and it's about a 5-hour drive from here, because again, this is the east coast of Canada, we're spread out, and I still have no one to drive me there, but we'll cross that bridge when we get there. But it's waterproof, and that's great, because again, I have to put drops on my eyes all the time, and wearing makeup on my eyes is tough. I can't go for more than a couple hours, because it starts to hurt. So, I tend to, like, leak a lot when I put the drops in and stuff, and this doesn't budge. And, I mean, is it the creaseless kind? Yeah, kind of. I mean, I have wrinkles. I'm 36. I mean, if you naturally have wrinkles on your skin, if you buy a creaseless concealer, like, there's still going to be creases, because you have, like, your skin bends and moves unless you're on Botox. Alright, move on. But, I like this. Let's move on. But I think that this NYX is a very good dupe for this Tarte, because I like it. The only difference, this is really thick. You do not need a lot. You need like 4 little dots and you just spread it around. I either use a really dense sponge or a brush. Like you can use your fingers if you want. But it does really cover. You don't need a lot. So this is $9, by the way. $9 compared to the $50 if I were to pay, no, I'll pay $9, no problem. Speaking of NYX, and drugstore finds, I did pick up this NYX glitter primer. So the glitter primer that I used before, you can see it, there you go. The glitter primer that I always had before was from e.l.f. I'm moving away from e.l.f. Cosmetics, not because they're not good. They are. They were my introduction to everything. I'm just moving up, I guess. And again, they were very not nice to me. And I haven't forgotten that, and I'm never going to. But, so we use this one. Again, I don't like wetting my brush and putting it into the pan. I don't like what it makes things come out as after. It hardens them a little bit, and that's just a personal choice. So I always put, like, glitter primer underneath, and then I put stuff on. I find that it does the same thing. That's a personal thing, okay, though. And I also happen to wear a lot of glitter, so it's good. Happy with that.